In 1666, the Great Fire of London devastated the city, destroying over 13,000 houses, significant structures such as St. Paul's Cathedral and the Royal Exchange, many warehouses full of goods, and many businesses. In his diary, Samuel Pepys provides detailed descriptions of London during the fire. "We stayed till it was dark almost, and saw the fire grow, and as it grew darker, appeared more and more, and in corners and upon steeples, and between churches and houses, as far as we could see up the hill of the city, in a most horrid, malicious, bloody flame, not like the fine flame of an ordinary fire. We saw the fire as only one entire arc of fire from this to the other side of the bridge, and in a bow up the hill for an arc of above a mile long. It made me weep to see it. The churches, houses, and all on fire and flaming at once, and the horrid noise the flames made, and the cracking of houses at their rooms." Christopher Wren designed the monument, as this column is simply known, to commemorate the Great Fire of London. The north panel records the devastation caused by the fire. "In the year of Christ, 1666, on the 2nd September, at a distance eastward from this place of 202 feet, which is the height of this column, a fire broke out in the dead of night, which the wind blowing devoured even distant buildings, and rushing devastated through every quarter with astonishing swiftness and noise. It consumed 89 churches, gates, the guild hall, public edifices, hospitals, schools, libraries, a great number of blocks of buildings, 13,200 houses, 400 streets. Of the 26 wards, it utterly destroyed 15 and left 8 mutilated and half burnt."